Greetings, wonderful audience. Amarjeet here from Amar PTE classes. I hope you all are doing fantastic. Do subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed yet, and share these videos with your friends and write your views in the comment box and your suggestions in the comment box. In this video, I am going to discuss how to improve the score in PTE. Means if your desired score is 60 and 80, then what are the points you have to remember while practicing and while preparing for this exam? So, points to remember. First one is get familiar with the exam pattern. Before starting your practice, you have to get familiar with the exam pattern. What are the different types of section and what are the different modules in different section, and which modules are important and which modules are contributing maximum points in the different sections. So get familiar with the exam pattern before starting your preparation. Second one is focus on spelling and grammar in the writing section. It is the most important point in PTE if you want to get score 60 plus and 80 plus. Means focus on spelling and grammar in the writing section, like write summarize written text, write an essay, summarize spoken text, listening, filling the blanks, and write from dictation. These tasks are most contributing in the PTE in different section, and focus on spelling and the grammar. If you are losing points in spelling and grammar, then you can affect your overall score in PTE. Third point is do proofreading in the writing section. After completing the task of the writing section, do proofreading. It is the most important, because if you are not doing proofreading, then it's the chances that you can get mistakes in the writing section. Next is the improve pronunciation and fluency. If you are losing your score in speaking section, then improve your pronunciation and work on your fluency. Means fluency and pronunciation is most important in the speaking section. Third part is the content. Then focus on your pronunciation and fluency. Next is click on the next button after completing the question. It's happened in the speaking section. You are waiting for the computer to get to the next question. But if you have finished your speaking, then click on the next button just immediately. Next is do not skip any question. Untap all the questions in speaking section, writing section, reading section, and in the listening section. So do not skip any question. If you don't know the answer, then attempt it. At least attempt that question. Next is understand the context. If you want to improve your reading, then try to understand the context and try to find out the correct meanings of the options, and use your basic knowledge of grammar, because sometimes we follow the basic grammar in reading, filling the blanks, and in reading and writing, filling the blanks. So understanding of the context is very important, and the basic knowledge of grammar is very important in reorder paragraphs as well. Next is practice mock test multiple times. If you are practicing, if you are preparing for PTE, then at least appear the mock test. At least appear in mock test multiple times as much as you can. Means improve your score, and your score should be improved. Because if you are getting 60 in the first attempt of the mock test, then in the second mock test it should be 60 plus, then in third mock test it should be 65 plus. So do practice accordingly, find out your weak areas and work on that weak areas. Next is practice with different accent and at different speed. Means if you are practicing for repeat sentence, then if you are practicing from write from dictation, then highlight incorrect word, then retell lecture and summarize spoken text, then always practice at 1.2. You can start from 1, but before filling your exam, practice at 1.2 and always with the different accents. Next is speak within 3 seconds or after the beep sound. It happens in the speaking section. Always try to speak within the 3 seconds, because if you are speaking after 3 seconds, then your mic will automatically get off. So always speak within 3 seconds and after the beep sound, like you will hear beep sound in the read aloud, then describe image, and the retell lecture. Remember this, there is no beep sound in the repeat sentence. And if you have any queries, then you can write in the comment comment box for more updates. You can follow my YouTube channel. And if you need any kind of help like online and offline classes, then you can contact me. My number is given in the description box, and share these videos with your friends. Thank you so much for watching this video.